improve from this. I need 60 points. Let's just try it and see what happens. Where am I? No, I didn't want to go home. No. New game. Yes. Because there's easy points here.
A lot of this isn't going to make sense to you, and I'm sorry about that. I'm just going to start at the beginning, with the house.
Oh, I played this through.
I lived here until I was 11, but I wasn't allowed inside half the rooms.
Red house.
I hadn't been back since my brother Lewis's funeral. In her will, my mother left me a key, but didn't tell me what it unlocked. Maybe she thought I'd know. Or she thought that the mystery would be enough to bring me back.
That's how Mom wants to go back.
The truth is, even after I inherited the house, I never thought I'd come back to it. But now I had questions about my family that only the house knew the answers to.
Walking over
the
this?
Woods around the house have always been uncomfortably silent. As if they're about to say something, but never do.
If we go up this way, easy 100. Then it's all done and dusted. Oh.
No one had driven this way in a long time, but I saw a few hoof prints.
There we go, that's it. That is it. Done it now. That's nice to know. Done. Still say 999. What an annoyance, it's not counting it. And it's nice to see the achievements going on to there too. No! I'm annoyed because this would have been over and done with. Come on! Turn 8! Did I not read it properly or something?
The house was exactly like I remembered it, the way I'd been dreaming about it. As a child, the house made me uncomfortable in a way I couldn't put into words. Now, as a 17-year-old, I knew exactly what those words were. I was afraid of the house. The house felt like it had always been here. Even the swing set was older than my mother.
Go through here.
Crawling through the doggy door used to be a lot easier when I was 11. For the first time in years, I felt like I was home. Nothing in the house looked abnormal. There was just too much of it, like a smile with too many teeth. Edie told me once that every Finch who ever lived is buried somewhere in the library.
Just going upstairs.
After Milton disappeared, Mom sealed up all the bedrooms. Then Edie retaliated and drilled peepholes. My Grandpa Sam spent 7 years sharing a room with his dead brother, Calvin. As a kid, I just assumed every house had peepholes and sealed rooms you weren't allowed inside of.
They probably do, you just, I don't know, things work around here.
The last time I was in Edith Senior's room, I was 10 and she was painting my portrait. Molly always seemed like a girl I could imagine being friends with, if she hadn't died in 1947.
Of course. It's another one.
Barbara was a child star for 2 years, until America grew out of it.
Go. Ah, for what's going to annoy me is that if I do this...
I spent a lot of time playing in Great Uncle Walter's room. Lewis told me there were secret passages, but I never believed him. Turns out, my mom was really good at keeping secrets. Now it was time to find out what my mom had been afraid of. Reading this, maybe it sounds like I had a plan, but I had no idea what was behind that door.
Here we go. Here we go.
Just like I had no idea where all this was gonna lead.
December 13th, 1947. Dear Diary, I'll be gone soon, but I wanted to tell somebody about what's gonna happen. It started when Mom sent me to bed without dinner. I woke up and I was starving, so I looked around for something to eat. The gerbil food was dry, but I didn't mind it. Mom, can I come out now?
Sweetheart, it's late. Go to sleep.
I kept eating and eating. I ate a lot of things that night.
Yum.
Then I heard chirping outside my window. It was a barn swallow going back to her nest. I reached out for her. And suddenly, I was a cat. I tried to be quiet, but the bird was really scared. Mom and Dad didn't even look at me.
I remember this puff so well.
I jumped and I almost got her. I could tell she was getting really tired. Now I was up in the big tree. I promised Dad I wouldn't climb it anymore. All I cared about was eating that mama bird. I gobbled her up.
I'm gonna turn into a shark.
Suddenly, I was an owl.
Oh no, owl.
First, all I heard was
right, so I just need
then I action. Heard little teeth nibbling in the grass. I imagined his face looking up and seeing mine through my talons. I swallowed him up, and I didn't chew one bit. Then I flew off to find something bigger. A mama rabbit. She was almost too big to carry.
That's another 100.
I was choking, but I couldn't stop eating. And suddenly, I was a shark.
Right, so 1 minute. There we go. Oh,
rolled off a cliff and into the ocean. Now, I was hungrier than ever. I wanted fat, juicy seals. I tore off her flipper, and it tasted really good. Everything had changed. Now I was a monster and I smelled people everywhere. I was big and I moved real quiet.
Might as well get another 300, another 100 points while I'm here. Fighting them more. Sailor, what should we do with a drunken sailor? What should we do? And more. Drunken sailor. One more line. Yep. Do with a drunken sailor. What should we do with a drunken sailor? Lie in the morning. Oh, up she rises. So
pipe. I got closer and closer. All my stomach started growling.
There we go.
And suddenly, I was me again. I held my breath for a long time, but I couldn't hear anything. I think it's waiting for me to fall asleep. But it's not going to wait much longer. It needs to feed, and we both know I will be delicious.
Okay. That was Molly.
I'm not sure if I believed all of that, but I'm sure Edie would have.
More importantly, I reached it. My aim was to get to the 100,000. It has been done. I am actually going to go and get some to eat. Well, thank you guys for joining me. And of course, until next time, thank you. Goodbye, everybody. See you later.